Hello, everybody. Well, to cut to the chase, I have had a very, very bad week. I have had an acute infection on top of the chronic Lyme and the ME that I have. And boy, it has knocked the socks off me. I used to be bedridden all the time with this illness, the Lyme disease and the ME. I have improved a lot from treatment overseas to where I get a few hours a day that I can go for a little walk and sit in the sunshine and just pot around. It's not high level energy or health, and I have treatments still every day, but it's a lot better than it was before. This week, not so much. It was quite a shock to the system, so I've mostly been bedridden this week, and it's such a hard illness, and to get another illness on top of that, yeah, it makes it really tough, and it puts pressure on family and friends and carers and people around you. So then it becomes emotionally hard as well as physically hard at the very time that you've got no physical energy to deal with it. So it has been a very rough week. But at my lowest points, because believe me, there were some low points, I've been nearly a quarter of a century sick. If you let that sink in for a little bit, what have you done in the last quarter of a century? Pretty much for me, I've been mostly bedridden. Not always. The early days, I did a little bit more, had a little bit more function. But for 23 years, from 1998, I've never had a day free from symptoms. Yeah, so I just get the best out of whatever I can. So yeah, it's pretty tough. And you get this little new normal where you get your few hours a day and you sort of go for your walk, and then that goes away again. It's like, it's harder than if you were healthy all the time and then got sick for a week. Because I can't afford to lose another week because I've got so much life to live. And I'm desperately trying to find a way to get a new normal. My new normal's here. Before was way down here, but I'd like to get way up there. So anyway, when I was at my lowest points this week, music is a saving grace for me. And some songs kind of filtered into my head, seemingly randomly, but there's always a reason that certain songs come to your head, and then you look up the lyrics and the lyrics tell you something that you need to hear at that time. And anyway, so tonight I was listening to music and healing my soul. And I started singing along to a few songs, and I thought, oh, why don't I just try and sing along and record it? Why not? So I'd already almost used most of my voice. You can hear it's pretty croaky anyway. I've been coughing my lungs up most of the week, so my speaking and my singing voice is definitely not at its best, and I am smashed right now. I know I'm smiling, but yeah, it's been pretty bad this week. And today, even mostly bedridden. So I made it to the couch. Ta-da! Welcome to my couch, everybody. So yeah, I thought I would sing along to this. I didn't do any practice. I just found the first track on YouTube that I could find, and I sang along with Katherine Jenkin. So thank you, Katherine, wherever you are. Sorry if I did an injustice. Definitely not my best attempt, but I will do it another day. Hopefully better when I'm feeling a little better. And in the meantime, I hope that you do enjoy it, and that it still brings some, just something to you. And it's really about, it's not about the perfect singing performance, because I know it's not tonight, but it's just about holding on to hope, and music gives me that hope. And just does something to the soul, doesn't it? So that's what this is about, really, as opposed to the actual singing being very good. but I hope you enjoy it. Okay, see you later. Bye. Right. Listen, Dorma. Listen, Dorma. Ne